Hello guys, this is Deep Shah over here, and today I'm going to show you how to create this custom sticker from a photo in Photoshop. So this custom sticker can be used to print it on sticker paper, or else you can use it to send it over WhatsApp as well. So if you want to keep learning such cool things using Photoshop, then hit that subscribe button if you haven't already. So without wasting any time, let's get started. So this is the model image whose face we will be using in order to create a custom sticker. So the first step over here we need to check is that we are using a high quality image. By high quality I mean that the width and the height of the image should be greater than 3000 pixels. Now in order to check that, you can go to image and then click on image size over there. So as you can see, the width is greater than 3000 pixels and height is also greater than 3000 pixels. After that, click on OK. So let's start with the actual effect. So the first step over here you need to do is make the selection of the face in the image. Now in order to make the selection, you can use quick selection tool or else you can use pen tool as well. Now you can select your option accordingly, but I'm going to use pen tool over here. So select pen tool and then using pen tool make a path of the face as follows. I'm going to zoom into the image for a proper selection. Now once you have created the path for the face, after that right click inside of the path and then select option make selection. And then click on OK. After that press Ctrl plus J to create a duplicate of the image which is inside of the selection. After that hide the background layer by clicking on the eye icon. So as you can see, we have separated out the face from the image. Now let's crop out the image and place the face properly. Select crop tool and then using crop tool crop the image as follows. And then click on the stick icon to crop it. After that, using move tool place the face properly. So now this looks proper. Now let's create a duplicate of this face image by pressing Ctrl plus J. Now let's rename the duplicate face image layer to face and original face image layer to backup. In case we do something wrong, we won't have to start from the selection again. After that, make the face layer active by clicking on it. Now we need to give this face image a somewhat cartoon look like effect. So for that, we will be following the 5 steps. So for that, go to filter and then stylize and then select option diffuse. After that, click on anisotropic option and then click on OK. Now we need to apply the anisotropic filter 3 more times, and each time we have to rotate the face image first. By rotating the face image, we will be applying the anisotropic filter from different angles. So for that, go to image and then image rotation and then select 90 degree clockwise. After that, again apply the anisotropic filter. After that, again rotate the image. And then again apply the diffuse filter. Again rotate the image. And then again apply the filter. And then finally rotate the image to normal. Now we have applied the diffuse filter from 4 different angles. So after that, the second step we need to do is smooth out the skin over here. So for that, go to filter and blur and then select option surface blur. After that, set the radius as 20 pixels and then threshold as 7 levels. So as you can see, it smooths out the skin of the model over here. Now the third step we need to do is make the edges of the face over here more sharp. So for that, go to filter and then sharpen and then select option smart sharpen over there. After that, set the amount as 200%. Radius as 2 pixels, remove Gaussian blur and then click on OK. Now the fourth step we need to do is make the overall image more sharp and give some contrast over here. So for that, go to filter and then sharpen and then select unsharp mask over there. After that, set the amount as 30%, radius as 50 pixels, threshold as 0 levels. So as you can see, we have added the contrast and make the overall image more sharpened. After that, click on OK. Now in the fifth step, we need to bring out the more details of the image. So for that, create a duplicate of the layer by pressing Ctrl plus J, and then go to Filter, and then Other, and then select option High Pass. After that, set the radius according to the details of the image you want. For this, 3 pixels look fine, and then click on OK. After that, change the blend mode of the layer to overlay. Now let me just show you the effect of the fifth step by zooming into the image and hiding the duplicate layer. So as you can see, more details are visible over here. Now let's zoom out again. Now after that, we need to merge the two layers into a single layer. So for that, press Ctrl and click on the face layer, which will give you the selection of the face layer, and keep the selection of the duplicate face layer. After that, right click inside of the layer and then select option Merge Layers. Now you can repeat the 5 steps any number of times by changing some of the values until you get a better effect over here. So now I'm going to repeat this 5 steps one more time over here. So let me just apply the diffuse filter. Now after applying the diffuse filter, let's apply the surface blur filter. I'm keeping the value same over here and then click on OK. After applying the surface blur filter, let's apply the smart sharpen filter. Now I'm going to decrease the values over here to half. After that, let's apply the unsharp mask filter. Now I'm going to change the value of the radius over here to half. Now let's create a duplicate of the layer and then apply the high pass filter. Now I'm going to reduce the value of the radius over here to 2 as well. After that, change the blend mode to overlay. And after that, merge the two layers. So now we have the face layer ready over here. Now let's give some background to make it look more proper. So for that, make the backup layer active by clicking on it. And then go to create new fill or adjustment layer icon. And then select option solid color. Now select any color which you'd like to give to the background. And then click on OK. After that, again make the face layer active by clicking on it. Now we need to add a white border surrounding the face, so for that click on Add Layer Style option and then select option Blending Options. After that, click on Stroke and then set the size of the stroke between 40 to 60 pixels. I'm setting it as 50 pixels. Set the position as outside, blend mode as normal, opacity as 100% and color as white. And then click on OK. After that, let's set some shadows over here. So for that, click on Drop Shadow and then set the following. Blend mode as normal, color as black, opacity as 15%, untick the use global light option, and then set the distance as 100 pixels and size to 50 pixels, and then click on OK. So now as you can see, we have the sticker ready over here. Now let's give some touch-ups to make it look more better. So for that, go to create new fill or adjustment layer icon and then select option use saturation. After that, set the saturation according to your image. I'm setting it as 15. And then click on create clipping mask icon and then minimize it. After that, let's add some more touch-ups. So for that, make the face layer active by clicking on it. Now we are going to add that red angry icon which we usually see in the cartoons over here. So for that, I'm going to open one another image. Download link for this image is in the description below. Now as you can see, this is what I was talking about, the red angry icon. So now we need to select this red angry icon from this image and drag it to our original image. Now you can make the selection using quick selection tool, or else you can choose the pen tool option as well. I'm going to choose the pen tool option over here because as you can see, the image is not that of high quality. So select pen tool and then using pen tool, make the paths as follows. So now once you have created the paths, after that create a new layer by clicking on create new layer icon and then right click inside of the path and then select option fill path. Now set the use as color and select any color from this red over here and then click on OK. After that, click on OK. After that, select move tool. And then using move tool, drag this layer at the original image layer. And then using Ctrl plus T, scale the image as follows. Press Shift while scaling to scale evenly. After that, click on the stick icon to place it. So now as you can see, our final sticker is ready. Now in order to use it for printing in a sticker paper, all you need to do is hide that drop shadow effect and then hide the background layer. After that, go to Image and then select option Trim. Then select the transparent pixel options and trim away from top, bottom, left and right, and then click on OK. After that, save this image as a PNG, give it any name, and then set the format as PNG, and then click on save, and then click on OK. So now that PNG image can be used for printing it on a sticker paper. Now if you want to use this sticker on a WhatsApp as well, then all you need to do is download the sticker.ly app and then import that PNG image into that sticker.ly app, and then click on add to WhatsApp option over there, and then you can start seeing the stickers in your WhatsApp as well. So that's it guys, this will give you a custom sticker from a photo in Photoshop. Now if you guys like this video, then hit the like button. Also share it to the ones who might be interested in such videos and subscribe to the channel for more videos in Photoshop. Thanks for watching. Bye bye.